Calhoun is dead. Keo crushed. Lieutenant Colonel Custer swings out beyond us with two companies, E and Alpha, probably about 80 soldiers. He goes out beyond the current cemetery, drops down the ridge, tries to cross the Little Bighorn River to the north. His motivation, capture all the women and children and old people who have run away from Reno's attack. Sitting Bull is leading them, but he cannot get across that river because Sioux and Cheyenne sentries one more time close the crossing forever. Custer is stymied in his advance. He has to turn around, fight his way back up through here where he drives warriors off the top of the hill and then digs in just about the same time that Keo caves in. Now, folks, the full fury of 1,500 to 2,000 warriors will bear down onto Last Stand Hill. The sky is raining arrows. Two Moons, the Cheyenne chief, we swirled around the soldiers like water around a stone. Gall, the soldiers were fighting good. They were loading and firing and loading and firing. But then about 30 or 35 of them, six or seven mounted the rest running. They bolted off the hill, blasted down towards the river. We caught them in the ravine and we killed them all. 28 dead men found at the bottom of this trail. E Company, the Gray Horse Troop, buried after the battle in a crack in the earth. Today, with the best archaeological equipment in the world, we cannot find a button, a bullet, a bone, anything that would prove that they ever existed. Now we call them the Mystery Troop.